Welcome once again to this lecture series in Chemical Reaction Engineering 2. Today we'll see solid catalyzed reactions. So here we consider a porous catalyst particle bathed by the reactant A. The rate of reaction of A for the particle may depend on these five factors: surface kinetics, pore diffusion resistance, particle delta T, film delta T, and film diffusion resistance. Surface kinetics, or what happens at the surface, interior or exterior of the particle. So here three steps are involved: adsorption of reactant A on the surface, reaction at the surface, and desorption of the product from the surface back to the gas stream. Then we have pore diffusion resistance, which may cause the interior of the particle to be starved for the reactant. So this will resist and will not allow the reactant to reach the interior surface of the particle within the pore. Then particle delta T, or the temperature gradients within the particles. These may be caused by the heat release. Then film delta T, this is between the outer surface of the particle and main gas stream. So particle may be uniform in temperature throughout, but hotter than the surrounding gas. And last, film diffusion resistance, or you can say the concentration gradients across the gas film surrounding the particle. So in real systems, for gas and porous catalyst systems, slow reactions are influenced by surface kinetics alone. So for slow reactions, the surface kinetics, which involves three steps: adsorption, chemical reaction, and desorption. So that will govern mostly. In faster reactions, pore diffusion resistance intrudes and it slows the rate. Then particle delta T and film delta T enter the picture. And finally, phi U, which can limit the overall rate, that is film diffusion resistance. In the liquid systems, the order in which they come into picture or intrude is 1, 2, that is surface kinetics, then pore diffusion, then film diffusion, and rarely particle delta T or film delta T. So this can be safely neglected in liquid systems. This table represents the factors which influences the rate of reactions of the particle. So these five influencing factors which we have discussed just now. So in porous catalyst particles, surface reaction is there, pore diffusion, this will come in picture. Particle delta T and film delta T are not likely, and film delta T is sometimes. So these are negligible, you can say, and there is no film diffusion or film mass transfer. Catalyst coated surface, surface reaction, yes. Film delta T and film mass transfer are important, and there is no, for catalyst coated particle, surface reaction, yes, and film mass transfer, yes. Pore diffusion and particle delta T. So 1, 2, 3, this number 2, number 3, and number 4 you can neglect, and these two are important. Burning of droplet of fuel. So only these two are important. First three can be neglected or not present there. Cells and living creatures. So this is for biochemical reactions. Surface reaction, yes. Film mass transfer could be there. Pore diffusion may be there, and these two, particle delta T and film delta T, are not there. So here you can see that surface reaction, so this term representing the surface reaction kinetics, is important in porous catalyst particles, catalyst coated surface, and biochemical reactions. So we have seen here all the phenomena which affect the rate in real practice or in real world, the reactions. We have to concern with all five factors at any one time. So this situation will rarely come, or we'll say we will never have to consider or deal with all five factors at one time in real systems. So it is very clear from this table. In fact, the majority of the situations with porous catalyst particles, mostly we will have to deal with first two, that is surface reaction kinetics and pore diffusion resistance. So these two resistances are to be considered most of the times, and will not come across a situation when all five need to be considered. Then for porous catalyst particles, now we'll see these factors which are important and given due consideration, due thoughts. Use of proper diffusion coefficient. So replace the molecular diffusion coefficient D by the effective diffusivity or effective diffusion coefficient of the fluids in the porous structures. DE values for the gases and liquids in porous solids are given by the Weiss in his publication in 1959, which is available in the open literature. Proper measure of the particle size. So characteristic size of the particle, which is nothing but the volume of the particle divided by exterior surface available for the reactant penetration and for any shape. So flat plate kind of shapes, it is thickness by 2. For cylindrical particles, it is radius by 2, and spherical particles, it is r by 3. So we'll have to use this in problem solving. Then measures of the reactant rates. So this catalytic system's rates of reaction can be expressed in many ways. So for first order kinetics, this is our usual based on volume. Minus 1 upon V dNA by dt is equal to KCA. Moles reacted per meter cube of whites per second. So based on the volume of the voids in the reactor, that is the free volume. Mostly the solids will occupy the volume, then gas or gas solid reaction, it will occupy the volume, and the based on the voids, it is moles reacted per meter cube of voids per second or per unit time. Based on the weight of catalyst particles, minus 1 upon W. So this prime, minus Ra prime and K prime is used for this. So moles reacted per kg of catalyst per unit time. Based on catalyst surface, minus Ra double prime, and this is K double prime. Minus 1 upon S dNA by dt. So based on catalyst surface, so moles reacted per meter square of catalyst surface per unit time. Based on the volume of the catalyst pellets, minus Ra 3 times prime, and this is K 3 times prime, minus 1 upon Vp, subscript P is used for catalyst pellet. So this is moles reacted per unit volume, is per meter cube of solid catalyst per unit time, and based on the total reactor volume. So this is void volume of the reactor. This term is equivalent to volume term in the homogeneous cases, and here the total volume of the reactor, VR, volume of the reactor. So moles reacted per meter cube of the reactor per unit time. So these definitions we will use, and we can have the relationships between minus Ra prime, minus Ra double prime, minus Ra 3 times prime, and minus Ra 4 times prime using these relationships in terms of volume, weight, surface area, volume of the catalyst pellet, and volume of the reactor. So this we will be using in problem solving. then we have seen the effectiveness factor small m into capital L ml. So this is also called as Thiele modulus, and it is represented as m subscript t, t for Thiele. Thiele modulus m subscript t. So in the manner similar to what we have done for single cylindrical pore, Thiele and Aries related this effectiveness factor with Thiele modulus MT for various shapes. So MT is equal to L into square root of K 4 times prime D. This we have seen, ML. This MT is nothing but ML. So for flat plate type, it is 1 by MT into tan hyperbolic MT. For cylindrical shape, it is 1 by MT divided by I1 into 2 MT by I0 into 2 MT. So this I are Bessel functions. Spherical particle, 1 upon MT into 1 by tan 3 times MT minus 1 upon 3 MT. So this also we'll see in problem solving. Then finding pore diffusion resistance effects for experiment. So we have to define other modulus which only includes the observable or measurable quantities. Only observable or measurable quantities. So Wagner, Weiss and Wheeler proposed this modulus, which is denoted as M subscript W. So M subscript W is nothing but Thiele modulus square into effectiveness factor, which is equivalent to L square minus RA 4 times minus RA 3 times prime divided by CA, which is based on the observed rate divided by effective diffusivity. Then we'll see the pore resistance limits. So for MT less than 0.4 or MW less than 0.15, when the reactant fully penetrates the particle and bathes all its surfaces, then the particles is in the diffusion free regime. So no diffusion. Other extreme is MT greater than 4, MW also greater than 4. When the center of the particle is starved by the reactant, a strong pore diffusion resistance is there. So for MT greater than 4, there is strong pore diffusion resistance, or you can say strong pore resistance. And for MT less than 0.4, no diffusion or diffusion free regime, no pore diffusion. Particles of different sizes. So we consider the sizes R1 and R2. So in diffusion free regime, that means where there is no diffusion, MT less than 0.4, minus RA1 prime by minus RA2 prime. So minus minus signs we have not considered here. So RA1 prime divided by RA2 prime will be equal to, this is K prime CA, K prime CA, and here we have epsilon 1 and epsilon 2 in the denominator. So this K prime CA will cancel out, and it is simply ratio of epsilon 1 and epsilon 2. And when this is approximately equal to 1, then you have diffusion free regime. Okay. Strong diffusion resistance, it will be there when epsilon 1 by epsilon 2 is equal to MT2 by MT1 which is not equal to 1 but defined by this ratio MT2 by MT1. This is Thiele modulus and Thiele modulus for size 2 and size 1, and that is R2 by R1. So inversely proportional, epsilon 1 by epsilon 2 is R2 is equal to R2 by R1. So this condition we have to test. If this is satisfied, there is strong pore diffusion resistance, and if epsilon 1 by epsilon 2 is equal to 1, if this condition is satisfied, then there is no diffusion or diffusion free region. So here the rate varies inversely. So this ratio RA1 by RA2 is equal to R2 by R1, that means inversely proportional. So for nth order irreversible reactions, MT is defined as L, this is characteristic dimension, characteristic length you can say, which is we have defined for different shapes, square root of n plus 1 k triple prime CAS, concentration of A at the surface, raised to n minus 1 divided by 2 times DE. So this is for nth order irreversible reactions. If you know K triple prime CAS order diffusivity and the dimension, you can easily calculate. So this is the plot of Thiele modulus, and on y-axis we have effectiveness factor. So this is on logarithmic scale, log-log scale. So you can see here, this represents 0.4. So less than 0.4, when Thiele modulus is less than 0.4, no resistance to the pore diffusion or diffusion free region. Here Thiele modulus is equal to 4. So in this region, when Thiele modulus is greater than 4, we have strong pore diffusion condition. And in between, both will have its own role, own contribution. So we cannot neglect one or other. So here for Thiele modulus less than 0.4, only condition is no resistance to pore diffusion, only the kinetics, chemical kinetics, that will be there. Here the strong pore diffusion for Thiele modulus greater than 4, so you have to consider this term also. This line represents epsilon is equal to 1 by MT. And these curves are for different shapes, sphere, cylinder and flat plate. So tan H MT by MT, and with different values of tan H MT by MT, that means for various values of Thiele modulus, you can calculate and you can approximate this, that we will see in problem solving cases. Then Froment and Bischoff propose this definition of Thiele modulus, generalized definition for any arbitrary reaction kinetics, minus RA triple prime into L divided by 2D integral CAE to CAS, CAE represent equilibrium concentration, minus RA triple prime DCA, this raised to 1 by 2. So for first order reversible reactions, MT is simply L into K triple prime by DE into XAE, and for nth order reversible kinetics, MT is equal to L into n plus 1 k triple prime CAS in raised to n minus 1 by 2DE. So these equations you have to keep in mind for first order. This is for first order reversible, and these are for irreversible nth order. So n can be any value. So for nth order reactions, combining the nth order rate with generalized Thiele modulus minus Ra triple prime is equal to K triple prime into CAS S to n into this effectiveness factor, which is 1 by T, 1 by Thiele modulus, 1 by MT. And if you write this for nth order kinetics, irreversible reaction, if I substitute for MT, you can write this equation as 2 by n plus 1 k triple prime into d divided by l square, square root of this, multiplied by CAS raised to n plus 1 by 2. So this is only the simplification of this. Thus, in the regime of strong pore diffusion, so for strong pore diffusion, when tanh ml by ml or tanh mt by mt is approximated as 1 by mt, and for Thiele modulus greater than 4, we have the condition of strong pore diffusion. So here the nth order reaction behaves like a reaction of the order of n plus 1 by 2. So this n, instead of n, because of this CAS raised to n from the rate law, it reduces to n plus 1 by 2. So for nth order, the reaction behaves as n plus 1 by 2. So for 0 order, n is equal to 0, it is half order. First order, 1 plus 1 by 2, it remains first order. Second order behaves as 1.5 order, and third order behaves as second order. Now we will see the performance equations for the reactors containing porous catalysts. So for plug flow conditions at steady state, material balance equation will give us input is equal to output plus accumulation in terms of moles of A per unit time. Here we have taken per second. So if you take this element of volume, small element of volume of catalyst delta V subscript S, what is entering? Fa in, that is Fa0 into 1 minus Xa in. Leaving is Fa out, Fa0 into 1 minus Xa out. Moles reacted per unit time, this is W into minus Ra prime or Vs into minus Ra triple prime. So this tau prime is WCA0 by Fa0, tau triple prime is VsCA0 by Fa0. So though this represents time, it will not have units exactly of time. So units are different, that you can see here. So tau prime, tau triple prime, and this can be related to our usual tau also, which has time units. So input Fa0 minus Fa0 xin. So Fa0 into Fa0 Xa in. So we can write this by solving this bracket. Fa0 minus Fa0 into Xa in is equal to output Fa0 minus Fa0 Xa out, accumulation term plus this minus Ra prime into delta W. If we write in terms of delta W, and then we can write in terms of delta Vs also. As we know, minus Ra prime dW or delta W is equal to minus RA 3 times prime dVS. Okay. So this FA0 will cancel out. This becomes plus FA0 is common, XA out minus XA in is DXA. So FA0 DXA is equal to minus RA triple prime DVS. If you integrate this, we can get W by FA0 is equal to integral 0 to XA out. If you start with XA in is equal to 0, DXA by minus RA, or you can write as VS by FA0. 0 to XA out DXA by minus RA triple prime. Here we have minus RA prime. So K dash tau dash, that is equal to K triple dash tau triple dash, same as K tau. So for first order case and variable volume is there, then you have minus RA is equal to KCA minus RA prime is equal to K prime CA. CA is equal to CA0 into 1 minus XA divided by 1 plus epsilon AXA. So, first order and variable volume, if you solve this, we get 1 plus epsilon A ln of 1 by 1 minus XA out minus epsilon A into XA out. So, this we have derived in CRE1 homogeneous reactions. So, you can refer to chapter number 3 and 5 from Octave Levenspiel to refresh your knowledge about this form, integrated form. So K tau is equal to 1 plus epsilon A into ln of 1 by 1 minus XA out minus epsilon A into XA out. For mixed flow conditions at steady state and for any epsilon A, simply we will have W by FA0 is equal to XA out minus XA in. If XA in is 0, simply XA out by minus RA evaluated at exit conditions means that RA out. VS by FA0 will be also XA out minus XA in divided by minus RA triple prime here at exit conditions. That means at A out, A at exit condition. If XA in is 0, then only simply you will have XA out by minus RA out. So this prime and 3 times prime, this we will use as the definition we are using based on surface area or based on volume of the reactor, based on the volume of the catalyst billet and so on. For first order reactions, when epsilon is equal to any value other than 0, not equal to 0, and CA in is equal to CA0, then K tau or K dash tau dash, and that is equal to K triple prime tau triple prime XA out into 1 plus epsilon A XA out divided by 1 minus XA out for mixed flow conditions. And when you have a batch containing catalyst and also a batch of gas, so in that case you have to apply this performance equation or design equation for ideal batch reactor. T by CA0 is equal to V by WS integral DXA by minus RA prime, or T by CA0 is equal to V by VS. So WS is replaced by VS, so minus RA prime is replaced by minus RA triple prime. So T by CA0 second into meter cube by mole. Then we'll see the extensions of these performance equations. So we have numerous applications of the catalytic reactions where the fractions of the solids, that is F or F subscript S we use, varies with height Z in the reactor. Z we are using for height. So here you can consider the condition where we have solids here and gas is passed from bottom, it travels towards the top, and we have here gas and solid. So for the first order case you will have exponential decay in the solid fraction here. Another case, if you consider here, and within this zone we have dense zone where large fraction of solids is there, and here small fractions of solids, lean zone. So the conditions will be different between these zones, whereas from here onwards the condition will be mostly uniform. So this also we will see in problem solving later. Now the same thing, this height fraction we are considering, and small element of volume represented by this small height delta z, which you can integrate from 0 to z. So here we have cross sectional area represented as A. FA in is UA CA0, U0 A CA0 1 minus XA in. FA out is U0 into A CA0 1 minus XA out. U is meter per second, let us say, and A is meter square. So this represents meter square and meter per second. So meter cube per second, volumetric rate. If U0 we consider as superficial gas velocity, superficial velocity means we consider that velocity as if the solids are absent, and this we are considering through this vertical reactor. We are considering a small element or a thin slice of height or this length delta z. We can write a steady state material balance. Input is equal to out plus this appearance. So input, what is entering? U0A into CA0 1 minus XA in. Output, what is coming out? U0A into CA0 1 minus XA out. And disappearance is minus RA triple prime into F, this fraction of solids, into A into DZ. Now if I rearrange the terms, I can write this as CA0 DXA. First term here cancels out. If you take this on this side, you get AA will cancel out because it is present everywhere in all three terms. Then CA0 into DXA divided by minus RA, that can be written as this F delta Z or DZ, and this U0 is taken in the denominator. If you integrate this, CA0 taken outside, integral 0 to XA DXA by minus RA triple prime, and that is equal to this U0 is constant, so 1 upon U0 F DZ integral 0 to capital H, where H is the height. So Z is varying between 0 to H. So we can use these expressions also for vertical reactors. Now we will look into experimental methods for finding the rates of reaction. So we can use any type of reactor with known contacting pattern to explore the kinetics of catalytic reactions, because here one is solid phase and we have only one fluid phase, either gas or liquid, present in these catalytic reactions under considerations. So we can find these rates with the same equation, same treatment as we have done for homogeneous reactions. So for fluid phase, the reactant either in the gas phase or liquid phase, we can use our analysis in the same manner which we have done for homogeneous cases. The precaution you have to take is you have to make sure that the dimensions of the equation, performance equation which you are using, is dimensionally correct. Means either based on volume of the particle, volume of the reactor, volume of the voids, surface area of the catalyst or weight of the catalyst. So all these definitions. So you have to be sure that the equation which you are using is dimensionally consistent and correct. So when you perform the experiments, you have to measure the extent of the conversion of the gas passing in steady flow through the batch of solids. So conversion as a function of time, any flow pattern you can use as long as the pattern selected is known. And if it is not known, then kinetics cannot be found. A batch reactor can also be used, and we'll see the different experimental devices. So differential flow reactors, integral flow reactors, mixed flow reactors, and batch reactors for both gas and solids. Differential reactor. So we have here a differential flow reactor. Here we consider rate to be constant at all points within the reactor. For each run in differential reactor, the flow performance equations can be modified and you use the average rate for each run, and each run gives directly the value of the rate at the average concentration in the reactor, and series of such runs gives the set of rate concentration data that can be analyzed for rate equation. So we can use W by FA0 integral XA in to XA out DXA by minus RA prime, and this average rate we can use minus RA prime average. So average rate, this is constant, you can take it outside the integral, and when you solve this integral, this is very simple, XA out minus XA in by average rate. So the treatment is simple. Integral reactor. So when the variation in the reaction rate within the reactor is so large, lot of variation is there because of variation in concentration. So we have to take into account all these variations, and we will have to opt for integral reactor. So rates are concentration dependent and large variation is there. So the composition of the reactant fluid is changing significantly in passing through the reactor. So we have to follow one of the two procedures which we have studied in homogeneous reactions in chemical reaction engineering 1 for searching the rate equation. Either you can go for integral analysis or differential analysis. In integral analysis, what you do is you use this performance equation W by FA0 is equal to 0 to XA DXA by minus RA, and then you test for first order, second order, zero order and so on, and then see the match, and if your data is matching first order kinetics, then you say the reaction is first order. If it's second order, then you say the reaction is second order and so on. If the reactions are not standard, zero, first order, second order, like that, then you have no option but to go for differential method of analysis. In differential method of analysis, you know you have to have concentration time data, large number of data points, then plot concentration as a function of time. Then at different concentrations, CA1, CA2 and so on, you draw the tangents. So minus dCA by dt will give you the minus RA value at corresponding value of CA1. So you get minus RA versus CA data. And then plot this. Minus RA is equal to K CA raised to N. Taking log of both the side, you get ln of minus RA is equal to ln of K plus N ln of CA. So when you plot it in Y is equal to MX plus C form, the slope will give you the rate constant. So minus RA will be DXA by differential of W by FA0 in this case.
then you can go for mixed flow reactor. So in mixed flow reactor, there is uniform composition throughout, perfectly mixed condition has to be there. The uniform composition in the fluid, same composition is of the fluid which is leaving the reactor. So the experimental devices which closely follows this ideal mixed flow reactor is devised by Carberry in 1964. It is called basket type mixed flow reactor for catalytic reactions, and another device developed by Berti for mixed flow reactor performance. The equation we have simple: W by FA0 is equal to XA out minus XA out divided by minus RA prime evaluated at exit conditions minus RA prime A out. So these are the typical sketches of this reactor, basket type reactor. So these are four spinning baskets which are spinning at high speeds. Uniform gas composition is here and same is XA out. So these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 baskets woven in wire which contains the catalyst pellets of total weight W. So fluid entering at XA in. So XA in may be 0 or may be having some value. Berti type reactor, here you have a feed and product, and here you have a spinning paddle in order to rigorously mix our fluid phase, and here we have catalyst and this is the spinning shaft. So these kind of reactor, Berti type reactor or Carberry type reactors, are used for catalytic reaction, particularly for gas solid catalytic reactions. Then we can use also integral reactor. So integral reactor performance equation, you know, W by FA0 is equal to R plus 1 into integral R by R plus 1 into XA final to XA final DXA by minus RA prime, where this R is the recycle ratio. And we know that when this recycle ratio is very low, we have plug flow conditions. Recycle ratio is very high, we have mixed flow conditions, and in between we have intermediate conditions. So for intermediate conditions, it is difficult to interpret the data. You have to match left hand side and right hand side. So for this kind of analysis, we ignore this regime, which is intermediate recycle ratio or even low recycle ratio. There is no point. Otherwise, for low recycle ratio means we are using plug flow reactor. But recycle reactor you can use as a mixed flow reactor for large recycle ratios. So if the recycle ratio is large enough, we have perfectly mixed flow conditions, and that we can achieve without any moving device. So this equation we use. So experimental type of reactor, recycle ratio is large enough to maintain the mixed flow conditions. So here we have a catalyst, fluid is entering, XA in is equal to 0 here, R plus 1 into V, this is the volume, metric rate, meter cube per second or meter cube per hour, whatever, coming out of the reactor. R into V is recycled again, and 1 into V means V is taken out of the reactor. And as this recycle ratio R is large, we have mixed flow conditions and we can use these ratios also. Then we can use batch reactor. So we have a batch of catalyst and batch of fluid, either gas or liquid. So in this system, what we do in batch reactor, we note the changing composition with respect to time. So from 0 to T, batch time, at different intervals, preferably at regular interval, you take out the sample and measure the concentration. So this concentration versus time data we will have in the batch reactor, and then we have seen interpretation of batch reactor data and you can find the rate law. So performance equation is T by CA0 integral 0 to XA DXA by minus RA, that is same as V by W, where V is the volume of the gas, DXA by minus RA, volume of the gas. In rate equations we have studied in comparison, we have called this volume of voids. Now these voids are filled by the gas. Further procedure of analysis is same as we have done in interpretation of batch reactor data, chapter number 3 of Octave Levenspiel in paper 1, we have studied this. So at any instant the composition is uniform throughout, and that is the condition, then you will get meaningful results or proper results. And this will be ensured when the conversion per pass across the catalyst is small. This batch reactor, we have a batch of catalyst here, catalyst weight W and batch of fluid for catalytic reaction. So here the fluid is in the uniform composition, or the concentration is uniform throughout at any time, and you take out the samples and follow the change in composition with time, that means you collect the concentration time data. Small composition changes, there is small composition change across the reactor, and this pump ensures the rapid circulation of the reactant. So we will stop here today and continue with the further topics in solid catalyzed reactions in our next lecture. So we stop here.